Resistance and conductance are more than just fundamental electrical characteristics. They're the backbone of why our electrical circuits work today. Hi, and welcome to the 2-Minute Guru. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and today we're going to talk about resistance and conductance. Resistance we measure in ohms, and conductance we measure in siemens, and they're actually inversely proportional to each other. So an interesting side note is that 1 ohm actually equals 1 siemen. Most of the materials we use in electrical engineering are either going to be highly conductive, like a wire, and we call those conductors, or they're going to be highly resistive, like, well, a resistor, and we call them insulators. Because air is highly resistive, it's a good insulator, and wire is highly conductive, it's a good conductor, we can create electrical circuits to control the flow of electricity. Let's take a closer look at what resistance is. Like most electrical characteristics, it really helps to think about them in terms of analogies that work for you. So make sure you find an analogy that works for you for each of the different electrical characteristics. This is the one I like to think of when I think about resistance. Resistance is a lot like drinking straws. Have you ever tried to drink out of one of these little stir straws? You have to work pretty hard just to get a little bit of your drink. That's like having high resistance. And then if you have a bigger straw, it's a lot easier to get your drink out. That's like having a lower resistance. You don't have to work as hard to get the same amount of liquid flow. So let's take a look at an example. I have a resistor hooked up to my power supply, supplying a constant 5 milliamps of current. And we're gonna see how much work my power supply has to do, how much voltage it's gonna apply to get 5 milliamps of current through this resistor. And if I look at this, it looks like it's about 1.1 volt to get 5 milliamps through this resistor. Voltage, current, and resistance all behave according to Ohm's law, which we will cover in a later video. Another interesting side note is that the unit of conductance is named after Wernher von Siemens, who founded a company by the same name. He is the one who established that electricity could be used as a power source. He invented the first elevator, he invented the trolley bus or the trolley, and he invented the electromechanical dynamic transducer, better known as a speaker. That's all we have time for today. Next time, we're going to talk about how to combine resistances. So make sure you subscribe to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel. The next few episodes are going to cover some EE basics, and then we're going to go on to learn how those apply to us in the lab every day. Thanks for watching. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff, and I'll be back with a new 2-Minute Guru video every other week.